Good morning, children. I am Mrs. Nahi Javeria, taking physical science for class 10th. We are into the first session of unit 7, classification of elements, the periodic table. As you all know, Robert Boyle in 1661 defined an element as any substance that cannot be decomposed into further simple substances. Towards the end of 18th century, 11 elements were discovered, and by 1865, about 63 elements were known. And by now, including synthetic elements, there are more than 115 elements. As the number of elements increased, it became difficult to keep in memory the chemistries of individual elements and their compounds. A German chemist, John Dobereiner, in 1829, noted that there were groups of elements with three elements known as triads in each group with similar chemical properties. Dobereiner's law of triads states that when elements with similar properties are taken three at a time and arranged in the ascending order of their atomic weights, the atomic weight of the middle element is the average of the atomic weights of the first and third elements. I hope you understood the point. The atomic weight of the middle element is the average of the atomic weights of the first and third elements. For example, in the first triad, if you see, we have got lithium, sodium and potassium. These three elements belong to one triad. So the atomic weight of lithium is 7 units, sodium is 23 units and potassium is 39 units. So if we take the average of the first element and the third element, that is 7 plus 39 divided by 2, we'll get 23. Okay, children. So 23 is the atomic weight of sodium. We can just check out for another triad where calcium, strontium and barium are there. The atomic weight of calcium is 40. Strontium is 87.5 and barium is 137.0. So here if we are taking the mean of the first and the third element atomic weights, we get 40 plus 137 divided by 2, which is equal to 87.5, which is the atomic weight of strontium. So these two are example for Dobereiner's law of triads. Now coming to Newland's law of octaves. The law of octaves states that when elements are arranged in ascending order of their atomic weights, they fall into a pattern in which their properties repeat at regular intervals. Every eighth element starting from a given element resembles in its properties to that of the starting element. Newland's was the first to assign atomic numbers to the elements. Now, if you just look at the table, that is the classification given by John Newland, he arranged the elements in octaves, that is hydrogen, lithium, germanium, all in a row, wherein these belong, this is the first element, so the eighth element from here is going to be fluorine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and this is the 8th element. So the properties of hydrogen resemble to those of fluorine. And this fluorine, again the 8th element from fluorine, if we consider, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and the 8th element is chlorine. So this fluorine, properties of fluorine resemble those of chlorine. Likewise, so hydrogen, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, all these belong to a same octave. Similarly, lithium, if we consider lithium as the first element, then the eighth element from lithium will be sodium. From sodium, if we consider the eighth element, we get potassium. So lithium, sodium, potassium all have similar properties, and all these have been placed in the next octave. But there were certain limitations in Newland's law of octaves also. In Newland's table of elements, That is, if we are starting at lithium, then the eighth element is sodium, and the next coming eighth is potassium, and so on. There are instances of two elements fitted into the same slot, that is, cobalt and nickel have been placed in the same slot. Cellurium and lanthanum have been placed in the same slot. Similarly, barium and vanadium, and platinum and iridium have been placed in the same slot. So, because of which this was a failure. And according to Newland's periodic table, it was restricted only to 56 elements. So, the next modification in the classification was given by Mendeleev. So, Mendeleev's periodic table. Mendeleev arranged the elements in a chart in a systematic order in the increasing order of their atomic weights. So, he divided the chart into 8 vertical columns known as groups and 7 horizontal rows known as periods. He said that elements in a group have similar properties and elements along periods have different properties. Mendeleev tried to explain the similarities of the elements in the same group in terms of their common valency. I hope you all remember what is valency. Valency is the combining capacity of an element. So, based on Mendeleev's periodic table, a periodic law was proposed. So, Mendeleev's periodic law states that the physical and chemical properties of the elements are the periodic functions of their atomic weights. This is your Mendeleev's periodic table. So, in Mendeleev's periodic table, we have got 8 different groups. Okay, so this is 1A group, this is 2A group, 3A, 4A, 5A, 6A, 7A, and 8A group. And also you have 3B, 4B, 5B, 6B, 7B, 8B. These 3 columns belong to 8B, 1B, and 2B. Okay, children. And the Mendeleev's periodic table had 7 periods. This is your first period, that is your horizontal rows. The second period, the third period, fourth period, fifth, sixth, and seventh period. And Mendeleev's periodic table also had some empty spaces in it. These 2 groups belong to S block elements. Okay, and all these groups towards your right represent the P block elements. And there were certain elements which were placed below the periodic table, which were later on known as lanthanides and actinides. Salient features of Mendeleev's periodic table, we'll just sum it up. There are 8 vertical columns called as groups, which are divided into 2 subgroups A and B. Elements present in a given group have similar properties. And there are 7 horizontal rows known as periods. Elements in a period differ in their properties from one another. Based on the arrangement of elements in the table, he predicted that some elements were missing and left blank spaces at the appropriate places in the table. He predicted the properties of these new elements in advance. He predicted properties of the elements, namely Ica boron, Ica aluminium, and Ica silicon, were almost same as those of scandium, gallium, and germanium respectively, which were discovered later. And the word Ica is a Sanskrit word for numeral 1. The placement of elements in the periodic table helped in correcting the atomic masses of some elements like beryllium, indium, and gold. And some anomalous series of elements like tellurium and iodine were observed in the table. The anomalous series contained elements with more atomic weights like tellurium, The atomic weight of tellurium is 127.6 units, which has been placed before the elements with lesser atomic weights like iodine. The atomic weight of iodine is 126.9 units. This is placed after tellurium, where the atomic weight of tellurium is more than the atomic weight of iodine. Now coming to limitations of Mendeleev's periodic table. Anomalous pair of elements. Certain elements of highest atomic weights precede those with lower atomic weights. For example, tellurium, whose atomic weight is 127.6 units, is placed before iodine. That is, it precedes iodine with atomic weight 126.9 units. And the second limitation is dissimilar elements are placed together. That is, elements with similar properties were placed in same group as subgroup A and subgroup B. For example, alkaline metals like lithium, sodium, potassium of 1A group have little resemblance with coinage metals like copper, silver, gold of 1B group. Similarly, chlorine is of 7A group and manganese is of 7B group, where chlorine is a non-metal and manganese is a metal. So, chlorine and manganese have been placed under one group, which is a contradiction. Coming to assignment, state Newland's law of octaves. Second question, give two examples of Dobrynin's triads. Third, state Mendeleev's periodic law. And the fourth question, what are the limitations of Mendeleev's periodic table? Thank you.